check, 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 check. Check, check, check. Check, check. Check, 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 check. This is like really quiet. Maybe it's up here. Check, 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 check. Check, check, check. Check.
Can you hear me? Hear me?
Yep.
All right.
We ready?
All right, we're here. It is the boys' regional co-championship. It's James Monroe to take on familiar foe, Greenbrier West. And we have pregame here. Tip-off will be here in just about 20 minutes. We got a special treat right now. It's Mary Beth Meadows up here with us. Girls are getting ready to head off to the state tournament right after this game. How you doing, Mary Beth?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Good. You had a pep rally today?
We did.
How was it?
It was good. The seniors won the spirit stick.
Oh, yeah?
Uh-huh.
Oh, good. So you're going to head up tonight. What's the plans for tomorrow? I know y'all are going to be up early heading over, right?
Yeah, I know we're going to watch a few games and just try to get our minds right. Andrew really hasn't told us much about what we're doing. I think it's kind of a surprise, but we're just going to be ready.
You got practice in here a little bit ago as before this game got ready for warm-ups. Any more practice on the agenda before tomorrow night?
I think we might get in a couple shots up, but other than that, I think we're good to go.
This is a good team you've got coming at you. St. Joe's, the 4 seed, you guys are the 5. So what's it going to take to get the win tomorrow night?
I think the main thing is to just stay calm and play our game and don't get sped up and play the pace that we need to play and stay in front and we'll be good. And rebound.
Yeah, I know you've seen a lot of this team over the past few days. You and your dad have been watching a lot of video. What do you see from them? What should we look for in the St. Joe's team we're not very familiar with?
They're all really smart basketball players and they move the ball really well. And I think that they're just going to come in with a strong game plan, and we just have to go right back at it.
Let's talk about your senior season here. You came in, had high expectations, beat Greenbrier West straight off the first game of the season, I think it was, here. Went and played a few tournaments, came back, had a pretty successful season all the way around in the state championship. Just reflect on the entire season and from where you are at the beginning to where you are now.
Well, we've had a lot of fun this season, and we've definitely had a couple games where our heads just weren't right, but I feel especially these last few weeks we've got our minds right. We're excited to play. We're wanting to play. So I think we've all just matured and realized how good that we can be if we are all working together. So I think that's the main thing.
How was the team? I mean, we saw you guys the other day as we were up here before the sectional title game, or sorry, the regional title game. And you guys look like you were having fun. The team's really come together and gelled as a group. Talk about some of the younger ones who were there and how they've contributed to the start.
Well, Maya, for starters, is like somebody that we rely on all the time. We can go for her for anything, and it's basically just like having another senior out on the floor and how well she's able to play. And Raleigh comes out and she always gives good minutes, and we know that if she goes in there she's giving it 100%, and we never have to worry when she's in the game. And even our players that don't get to play as much, they're always having energy, they're always cheering, helping us, giving us water on the bench. So everybody has really bought into it and they know their roles and they play their roles, and it's really good.
You guys got a chance to go this week. I know you went to Union and were able to read to some of the kids.
Yeah.
I don't know if you got to Peterstown or not.
Yeah, we did today.
You did today. So tell me about that and being able to do that and just how your passion and playing of basketball has led into being able to have some impact with those younger ones.
So going to read to them was probably the funnest thing we've done all year. there wasn't a classroom that we went into that some little girl or boy wasn't giving one of us a hug. So I think it definitely impacted us, because I think a lot of times we think about all those little kids and how much they look up to us, and even though we're not really that important right now, they think that we're the most important people ever. So it's really good to feel that way.
Yeah, I think they really look up to you guys. I know they did last year when the boys went to those title games. Yeah. They got to go do some of the same thing. And how do you think it's impacted some of, especially the younger girls coming up who are looking at what they want to get into? I know there's, at Peterstown anyway, where I'm familiar with, there's a really big movement with girls basketball. Pretty good teams coming up through there, both at the middle school level yeah. and the Little League.
I think those girls are some of the most athletic middle school girls I've ever seen, and I think that they look at us and they want to do what we're doing. So I think when they get up here, they're going to really buy into the program like we do, and I think they'll be really good.
Yeah. So you guys are going to head up right after?
Yep.
Is there going to be any kind of send-off is planned?
Well, hopefully when our boys win, we're going to – the buzzer is going to go off, and they're going to say – we're leaving, and we're going to leave, and people are going to cheer for us, and then the boys get to cut down the net.
You're in the student section tonight. I think you're one of the student section leaders. So what do you got planned down there for this one?
Well, we're going to be loud. We're going to bring energy.
Tomorrow's a blackout night, right?
It is. Tonight's whiteout, and tomorrow's blackout.
All right, so if you're going to the state tournament tomorrow, make sure you have black on. They want to darken the entire place, from what I understand.
Yep.
See, I think there was something else I wanted to get into with you. Maybe it wasn't. Maybe we covered it all. Give me your final thoughts. So you're heading in. You played your last game here. You got to cut down the net, and now you're going to head up to Charleston. You got one more weekend of high school basketball. How's it feeling?
It's bittersweet. It's really exciting to make it to Charleston finally after 3 years, but just making it doesn't really mean as much as it would to win. So I think we want to get up there and win a game, and then it'll feel a lot better.
One game at a time, right?
Yeah, one game at a time.
All right. Mary Beth Metis, girls are going to head up to states right after this, and hopefully it might be the first time ever the boys and the girls go to state in the same year. So we'll find out that tonight. But it's going to take James Monroe taking on this Greenbrier West team to do that. We're about 12 minutes from tip-off. We're going to take a quick break, come back, and we'll talk about the one ahead of us.
The State Farm Personal Price Plan helps you create an affordable price just for you. Contact local agent Melissa Hilton for your personal price plan today.
Reno Medical Center is located in the heart of Reno and has provided quality health care to our community for over 45 years. We offer medical, dental, pediatrics, pharmacy, behavioral health therapy, x-ray, mammography, diabetes education, and on-site lab services. We accept most insurance plans and offer a sliding fee scale for qualifying patients. Make us your family's medical home and let us care for you. Reno Medical Center. Excellent health care right at home.
Western Auto in Raynell is the solution for all of your automotive repair needs. We carry snow blowers, wood splitters, propane heaters, and a full line of Husqvarna saws, bars, and chains. And most importantly, service after the sale. We also carry Whirlpool washers and dryers, freezers, refrigerators, and hot water heaters. We have enjoyed serving our community for 48 years and support our Greenbrier West Cavaliers.
The 2023 West Virginia State High School Girls Basketball Championships, presented by Chick-fil-A, will be held March 5th through 9th at the Charleston Coliseum in Charleston. Come join the fun of Championship Week.
The West Virginia Secondary School Activities Commission serves its 286 member schools and their students by providing leadership and support for the conduct of education-based athletics, which enrich the educational experience of all participants. Play, perform, compete together. Today's athletic event is not about winning at all costs, disrespecting others, or criticizing the athletes, coaches, or officials. It's about learning and growing, developing character, and competing with class. Please keep it positive and bench bad behavior. The West Virginia Secondary School Activities Commission promotes athletics that provide lifelong and life quality learning experiences to high school students while enhancing their achievement of educational goals. Play, perform, compete together.
Chick-fil-A and its 18 West Virginia owner-operated restaurants salute the more than 86,000 boys and girls that participate in scholastic sports in our state. Chick-fil-A recognizes that participation in high school sports helps to develop leadership and teamwork skills that prepare each participant for life. The same values that Chick-fil-A in your community shares. Chick-fil-A, proud to support West Virginia high school sports.
We're back here about 6 minutes till tip-off. It is the Imrockstone Manufacturing pregame show, and we're here to talk about what's coming up. It's James Monroe versus Greenbrier West in the regional co-championship. So let's look at what we got here. These teams have faced each other a couple times this year, and it has been a barn burner each time. Here at home, about a month ago now, it was an overtime game. James Monroe was able to come away with a win, and a few weeks later, they went up to Charmco. Got the win there as well in another close game. Not overtime, but close. And the one here, Brady McClung put up 39 points for the Cavaliers. What do you think tonight coming into this one, James?
Well, it's you know, Greenbrier West, the team, they play on emotion a lot. You know, they're definitely scrappy, and they more so than probably any other single-A school, they seem to have, you can't say they have James Monroe's number because they've lost both times, but they've come as close as anybody to figuring James Monroe out. You know, if you're James Monroe, you got to be a little bit nervous because you don't get any do-overs. This game right here, it's not like, well, we'll get them later on in the season. When you have a team like James Rowe has and has had the past couple years, you always wonder about that little pebble in the road, you know, that's going to cause you to crash.
Yeah.
The trick to it is not let that come over and rule your mind. But James Rowe definitely has to be, and I'm sure Coach is giving Greenbrier West his due regard right now, because if you don't, they'll send you back home.
Yeah, I know this team Coach Savage respects coming in, Coach Robertson. Respect on both sides of this. When I've talked to either of these coaches, that's one thing that is evidently clear, is they have a lot of respect for what the other team brings to the table, and nobody's overlooking this game. It was 3 years ago, close to 3 years ago to the day, as a matter of fact, when James Monroe lost to this team and what would have been their first trip to a state title with the group, the team that's there now. Lost that game in overtime.
Yeah.
And the next 2 years, of course, they won and went on to win state tournament games. But that game was a game that those guys, Eli and Josh and Colin and all those guys, they remembered that one for the entire time they played. You know, they talked about remembering that game every day, and it was part of what fueled them on their way to those two state title games. The guys who are up here right now, the oldest of them were freshmen when that game happened.
Well, that game was a good example of they let them get back into that game. Then it went to overtime, you know. And you can kind of feel, at least I did, I can remember very clearly when that game went to the first overtime, I kind of had this feeling, well, you know, James Rose, they've lost. When they went to that first overtime, I thought, you know, they've lost this game, and lo and behold, that's what happened. So, you know, it's kind of one of those, parables, mm-hmm. you know, a lesson learned.
Mm-hmm. Jason Moe looking to three-peat this year. Of course, it'd be the first time in school history that's happened. The ladies' team had a back-to-back title run in the early aughts, and almost a three-peat, lost in a championship game that third year. James Monroe needs to win this game if they want to keep that dream alive of being the first time to do that. Also, a potential of a first time that girls and boys teams would go to states in the same year.
Since you've had since the era of consolidation, which I guess will be starting back in the
94.
Well, not here. I mean, throughout the state, probably in the early 90s.
Yeah.
Has there been a dynasty like, you know, the old Big Creek teams or the team over in Wyoming County there from years ago? There hasn't been anyone like that I can think of. There's been several teams that go.
Yeah, that have been up several times that that have won multiple championships. But as you're talking about going years and years in a row, I don't think there's definitely not been anything like what we saw with, you know, some of those teams you talked about, North Fork and those groups that would win, you know, 10 titles in a decade kind of thing. In football, AA, Bluefield's had some runs. Independence has had some runs. Polka has had some runs in AA. As far as single A and triple A, I think it's been more spread out.
Well, I think it just popped in my head. It's completely off the subject. I'm not trying to make a point here, but, you know, back in the day, if you were a single A team, you were a single A team. They weren't going to completely keep adjusting the divisions as far as that goes. And now, you know, every couple of years, you know, you're a triple-A team. Now you're a double-A team. Now you're a triple-A team again. You know, so constantly adjusting the competition there. I'd say it probably has something to do with it. While we haven't seen teams like that.
Another fine point is this will be the last game of James Monroe playing in single-A competition in a regional for a while. At least they're going to move up to double-A next year. We'll be in a region more with Wyoming East, Bluefield, Summers County, Mingo Central, I think, some of those schools. So it'd be a whole different group of faces coming around. Sure, we'll still see some of these rivalry games intact through that, though. We're down to about under 20 seconds to go here. You've been listening to the M-Rock Stone Manufacturing pregame show. We're just about ready to get this one underway, folks. One everybody's been looking forward to. We got that big game against Greater Beckley last week, won it, and that's what's got us in this gym and not in Webster County right now.
And it was good to see them play Greater Beckley because it's a little different style of team than anything, you know, that they see other throughout the regular season other than them. It's nice to see them be able to adjust.
So let you listen in to Aaliyah Hill, the national anthem.
starting lineups. This place, you stand up and look around, absolutely packed right now, Jamie. Standing room only down on the lower end.
Yeah, then
Tanner Hagee announced first out.
And it's a good two-thirds of the bleachers up here in the mezzanine are...
There's Braden McClung. We know all about him. Isaac Agee. Chris Davis and Colton Dunbar will be last off the bench. Now the starting lineup for James Monroe. Looks like it's going to be your standard five from throughout the season. Ryan Mann, Leighton Dowdy, Brady Baker, Ryan Cole, and Cooper Ridgeway.
You know, one of the things that we hardly ever have to talk about, but I believe it may be crucial in this game for James Monroe, is staying out of foul trouble. You know, it's usually not an issue with them, but the way these teams play, you know, depending on how the game is going to be called, there needs to be real cognizant of how many violations they're picking up.
Yeah, and they're going to have to deal with two pretty talented guards here tonight in Tanner Hagee and Braden McClung. And we saw they had that similar kind of matchup against a strong group of guards in that Greater Beckley game. So they will test it. It's going to be Dunbar and Cole in the center circle to get things started. Whistle blows, and we are ready to get it on. Ball's up, and it's tipped back. Going to be controlled by the Mavericks. Mann hands to Dowdy, and here we go. Cross midcourt, works left side, picked up by McClung. Now he's going to come to Ridgeway. Ridgeway inside to Cole. Cole spins as he works against Davis. Or, sorry, it's Isaac Agee. Ridgeway gets a pass into Dowdy. It's not able to be handled, but I think Brayton McClung got a hand on it because he dove for it. Well, thinking he needed to save it, and then it goes out of bounds.
No real mystery is what Wes is doing. They're just packing up the inline down there all along the baseline. You never saw less than four, never saw less than three. Most of the time, four defenders just piled up along the baseline.
Three in the air from Dowdy, and he gets it with a defender in his face.
So if you want to bring those players or defenders off the baseline, that's how you do it. Score from up top.
McClung with the ball now. He likes to get into that mid-range jump shot if he can. We'll see if the Mavericks let him get into that area and try to trap as they've done before, or if they have a different plan this week. Peggy with the ball now comes back to the top to Dunbar. Dunbar looks for somewhere to go. Looks. Now gets it back to McClung. McClung down to the left side. It's that area he likes, and they double-team him as he gets in there. He has to work back to the top.
And James Rose, as long as their switches go smooth, they could do that. Just...
And we're going to get a travel on Hagee. It's kind of the one we've seen and talked about. Just let that pivot foot move before you start your dribble.
Yeah, boys and girls, all season long, the refs have been calling that foul, and nobody seems to have learned from it yet. Because here we are, postseason, teams are still doing it.
Yeah, been a point of emphasis, even over the past couple of seasons. Now Ridgeway with the ball, goes right side, back in toward the foul line, gives up his dribble, comes back to Mann. Mann at the top of the key, gives a head fake. Now he's going to dish it off to Dowdy, back to Ridgeway. Ridgeway's going to reset the offense as Brady Baker creeps out toward the high post. Ridgeway dribbles left, gets the man. Mann goes in, has to turn out into the corner to Ridgeway. Ridgeway's going to post up, pushes up a three, just a bit strong. Mann with the rebound, gets the floater up and goes. And that is a rare three attempt by Cooper Ridgeway, yeah. But it's going to give them something to think about because it was a good-looking shot.
Well, you know, when he does take that shot, he has some success there.
Peggy with the ball. It's a 5-0 lead for the Mavericks early. Into the corner to Davis, back to the top to Hagee. Hagee watched by Dowdy. He's going to get a screen from Dunbar. Breaker switches out. Now they get it to McClung. McClung's going to drive left side toward the baseline. Works underneath. Pass out. That's to Davis. Shot up. No good. Rebound. Fought for. Out of bounds. Going to be out on Dowdy, it looks like. loud crowd here tonight. Pass from A.G. into Heggie. Three on the way, and he got it.
Yeah,
he had Dowdy right on top of him, but got up and over.
Oh, now they're going to press off the inbounds play. And
long pass up to Cole. He gets it. Now gets a pass into Baker. Baker bodies up, goes up strong, and gets the points.
Yeah, did everything he could to try to draw the foul there.
A lot of contact underneath, but going to get the two, and that's it. 7-3 here as we tick down toward 5 minutes to go. McClung with the ball. Drives right side. Baseline. Shot up off glass. Won't go. Man there for the rebound. All the way up to Baker. Baker's going to have to run it down. Has to track it over in the corner and tries to get it to Dowdy. It was knocked out of bounds by Heggie. As to Dowdy, he thought about the shot. Now he's going to set things back up as McClung was able to close out. Down to Mann. Mann pushes up the three. Just misses. Rebound by Cole. And travel.
I believe Ryan, I think he picked up two, possibly three traveling calls like that, that quick step. Yeah, just it's so tempting what he wants to do.
McClung with the ball. Heggie and Dowdy got tangled up. Dowdy went down, was able to get himself back up. Now McClung with the ball. He takes a jump cut
and
a travel. Extra step after the jump cut.
Yeah, I think his feet both left the ground. Yeah, Heggie and Dowdy, they got tangled up there. And Heggie actually, in the midst of the play, reached out and picked him up, helped him up off the ground. It's a rivalry, but always good-hearted, good sportsmanship displayed here, both these teams.
Man with the ball. Looks to go somewhere. Covered up good. Now finds Cole. Cole at the top of the key. Goes to Ridgeway. Ridgeway gets it to Dowdy. Dowdy has it almost taken away by Heggie, but he's able to recover and goes back to Ridgeway. Ridgeway calls the play from deep in the half court. Now to Dowdy. Ridgeway cuts, and man's behind him. Gets the ball. Dribbles in. Goes up for the shot, and he's going to be fouled. Gets a hand on the wrist, and he'll head to the line for two. Little play there. Went to the wing. Ridgeway cut through, and Mann was right on his heels. Ridgeway pulling the defense with him. Gave Mann a little bit of room. The defense closed out, but Mann was able to draw the contact.
Yeah, kind of almost like plowing snow there.
Yeah. Shot goes, and it's 9-3 now as we're under 4 minutes in the first.
No pressure from James Monroe at all, either half court or full court press off of any inbounds play this far.
Davis works into the post, turns. That's an attempt up, a block from Mann, but they say there's a foul. Got some of his hand along with the ball. Two shots coming here for Chris Davis. First foul shots of the night for the Cavaliers. Shot on the way, in and out. He'll have another. Second one, got it. Here's a full court press. They get a trap on Dowdy. He's able to get it up to Ridgeway. Ridgeway comes across, fires a pass in to Baker, but miscommunication there, and it's errant into the wall.
Yeah, just a very low pass. It's kind of, everybody just kind of watched it going by. I think Baker thought that it had been touched by the defender there, so he didn't make a stronger effort to go grab that ball.
Davis with the ball, finds McClung, and he'll have it at the top of the key as he's watched by Ridgeway. Ridgeway never taking his eyes off of McClung. Heggie with the ball in the corner now. Goes to Dunbar. Finds McClung. McClung drives in. Takes a step around. Tries to go up, but it's blocked. And they say out of bounds on West. About four or three Maverick bodies in there. That ball could have bounced off of, but somehow it came off of a blue jersey. And they're going to get it to Mann now. Mann trapped back to Dowdy. Dowdy with a hard pass back up to Mann. He's able to break midcourt. Into the corner to Cole. Open three from the left side. Got it.
Yeah, if Cole gets started here and he starts dropping those threes, you know, he's kind of a streaky shooter. If he's going to miss, he'll miss all night. But if he doesn't, you better watch out.
Dunbar with the ball, turns and gets a post position on Baker and is able to go up over top and get it off glass. 6-12 now. We'll see the press from the Cavaliers again, but the Mavericks able to get it across midcourt. Dowdy with the ball, gives up his dribble, comes back to Mann. Mann finds Ridgeway. Ridgeway's going to work back up to the top, goes to Cole. Cole drives baseline, turns back up to Dowdy. Dowdy's going to get an open three from the left wing, and he got another one.
I believe that's the fourth three of the night for James Monroe.
Yeah, I believe it is.
So there's a 15 points
other
on the
points were on
15 points on the board, yeah, 12 the, of them from beyond the arc.
The Baker post and the foul shot are the other two, or 3 points, 15-6 with under 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. And McClung with the ball. He's guarded by Ridgeway. Going to get a screen from Davis, and we get
5 second violation.
Yeah. We're going to have Damian Dixon check into the game. See, looks like he's going to get Chris Davis a break, and it seems like maybe some nerves on the part of the Cavaliers
I believe
here.
McClung just nobody was listening to him. He kept trying to set the offense, and I don't think he was getting had anybody's ear.
Yeah, into Baker. Baker gets it back out to Dowdy. He's going to get another three. Just misses. Rebounded by Cole. He turns, gets it up, reaches his own rebound, goes up again. He's blocked, but the long rebound goes out to Dowdy. He gets it to Ridgeway. Ridgeway's going to drive in. He goes up hard, and offensive foul. Ridgeway went down hard. Looks like he's all right. Maybe he caught his lip.
I believe he was on the ground counseling himself about taking that one extra step and wishing he had pulled up.
1:10 on the clock as it rolls. 15-6, first quarter. Ball out to Isaac Agee. He finds Hagee. Hagee's going to drive left down to the low post. Gets a shot up, and it rolls everywhere but in. My goodness. And a rebound brought out by Dowdy. A lot of contact underneath. It's a physical game so far. Ball out to Dowdy. He's going to cross midcourt under 45 seconds now to play in the first quarter. Mavericks don't have to be in a hurry here. Have a 9-point lead. They're going to get it to Mann. Mann head fakes. Goes to the left high post. Now comes back around to Dowdy. Dowdy guarded closely by Hagee. Or sorry, that was Dixon. Dixon watching Dowdy. We're out under 30 seconds now. They get it to Ridgeway. Ridgeway looks inside. Now he's going to get it over to Cole. Cole thought about the three into the corner to Dowdy now. Dowdy back up to Ridgeway. Ridgeway's going to drive in baseline, loses the ball, and it'll be off of Damian Dixon. 15.5 on the clock. We're going to have Levi Ramsey come in. He's going to get Isaac Agee.
There's going to be some little short inbound play there, or they're going to try to set it for
comes in to Cole, works to Ridgeway. They're down to 10 seconds now. They're going to be able to hold this for the last shot. They've spread out, give an isolation here to Ridgeway. He's going to drive in, gets underneath, shot up and in at the buzzer. And it's going to be 17-6 as we go to our first break. Mavericks ahead. We'll be right back.
Reno Medical Center is located in the heart of Reno and has provided quality health care to our community for over 45 years. We offer medical, dental, pediatrics, pharmacy, behavioral health therapy, x-ray, mammography, diabetes education, and on-site lab services. We accept most insurance plans and offer a sliding fee scale for qualifying patients. Make us your family's medical home and let us care for you. Reno Medical Center. Excellent health care right at home.
So it's, hold on, it's.
All right, and we're back. Heggy with the ball down around the left corner. He's going to get it back up to Dixon. Dixon hassled there by man actually falls down, and now it's taken away from Heggy. Cooper Ridgeway with it. He's going to go up and lays it in. And rolls in.
Well, we saw Wes coming out there trying to open their offensive end up. You know, spread out basically the four corners. Not four corners play, but
and four gets the position. Floater to go on this in contact. No call.
That's
It'll
what.
Count.
But that's what they were wanting to do the last time, was open up the middle so that he can drive and do what he does best.
Open three from Cole. He got another. Oh, the press Pema really hurt him there because they had no defender down there for Cole.
Well, they've caused some problems with the press, but they've not even so much generated a single turnover from it since they've ran it. You just wonder how long they were going to stay in it when they're not getting any benefit from it.
Have a chance here with, I think, Chick-fil-A, and it's 18 West Virginia owner-operated restaurants. Salute to more than 86,000 boys and girls that participate in scholastic sports in our state. Chick-fil-A recognizes that participation in high school sports helps to develop leadership and teamwork skills that prepare each participant for life. The same values that Chick-fil-A and your community share. Chick-fil-A, proud to support West Virginia high school sports.
We're preparing to...
And do we have a technical call?
Apparently, I don't know. Colton Dunbar was standing there having a chat with the ref prior to this, and the coach and Colton from Greenbrier West were both having a chat with him.
He got a free throw. Mavericks are going to take the ball. It was a technical. I'm not sure who it was assessed to.
The coach is still having words with Dunbar on the bench as he's out of the game now, so...
It's a 23-8 game right now, 15 points.
The universal language of calm down and shut up being demonstrated over there on the Greenbrier West bench.
Yeah. They get a foul.
It's a little reach-in holder kind of deal.
Dixon, yeah. Also, thank Monroe County Sheriff Vote Michael Heller, continuing duty and service to our county. Dowdy going to drive in, lose the handle on the ball, gets back out to Cole, pushes up a long three, in and out. We'll go Baker with the rebound, and he's tied up. He'll be fouled on the floor.
Yeah, and that's going to be Braden McClung. I think it's his, is this his second. Oh, I'm sorry, they didn't call it on him. They called that on Levi Ramsey. I don't even. Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
he's on the floor.
First foul on Ramsey. And now Cole with the ball off the inbound. Gives up his dribble. Comes back to the top. Ridgeway going to get the shot off. Can't get it to go. Rebound brought out by McClung. McClung runs the court. Pass down low. And he gets it in. That was Chris Davis who was able to score.
Credit all that to McClung there. Smallest guy down there amongst the trees comes out with that rebound because he knows where to be in relation to the basket. Hustles the ball down the court, sees his open man there. He's just a problem no matter what he's doing.
Dowdy with the ball in the corner, guarded tightly by Dixon, and very tightly. He'll actually foul on the reach-in.
While they're straightening all that out, substitution being made, let's talk about the Girls' Championship. The 2024 West Virginia State High School Girls Basketball Championship presented by Chick-fil-A will be held March 5th through the 9th at Charleston Coliseum in Charleston. Come join the fun of Championship Week.
It's going to be a lot of fun. Action started today.
Yeah, we'll see you down there.
Oh, and able to go into the backcourt. Okay, interesting. That call was made from the referee across the court instead of the one right in front. Maybe some confusion on if he could enter the backcourt.
Yeah, it's whether you could off that.
It was no question that he entered the backcourt. The question is, was he able to? And I think the opposing referee said he's not.
He knew he wasn't supposed to because he was doing his best not to. So,
I think they got it right. And the ball out to Dunbar. Dunbar finds McClung. Three in the air. Got it in front of Ridgeway.
And there's a little softer press here, a little token resistance there to kind of slow the ball down that time from West. as we've seen this happen before, time and time again, James Ray will come out, open up a little bit of a lead, and West will claw back a point here and a point there and tighten the ball game up.
And man, with the ball, gets it into Baker, and just a hard pass to handle goes off of his knee.
Yeah, those awkward bounce passes that don't bounce up above a big man's knees rarely end well.
Yeah. Also, I'd like to thank Elect Miller for share of honesty, integrity, and commitment. Along with Kristen Cook for circuit judge, Monroe and Summers County's Republican running for a nonpartisan position. Hashtag vote Cook. McClung with the ball. Gets into the low post. Turns. Gets into Ridgeway. Gets it up off glass. It won't go. He was doing everything he could to draw contact on that. They're going to get that over to Cole now. Cole comes back to the top to Ridgeway, and they'll set the offense from there. Three in the air. Doesn't get that one to go. Was that Ridgeway again?
I'm not sure. Somebody got pushed off there. Yeah,
it's going to go against the Mavericks. Let you know who in a moment. It's going to be Ryan Cole's first foul. Score 13-23. Mavericks have been up as much as 13. Up 10 at the moment. Just about 4.5 minutes to play here in the first half. Ridgeway guards. McClung goes to Dunbar. Now to Davis. Davis is going to push up a three. That one won't go. Rebound brought out by Mann. He had to save that. Just he was going to fall out of bounds as he went to get it. Now he gets it back. Goes to Ridgeway. Ridgeway will set the offense from the top. Comes around to Dowdy. Dowdy's going to push up the three. Can't get the roll. Just left it a little bit short. Rebound brought out by Dunbar. He's going to get it to McClung. All the way up top to Agee. Agee not able to finish. Had a good look at the basket. Just wasn't able to get it to go. Now gets it to Mann. Mann tied up, and he goes inside to Ridgeway. Ridgeway's going to go up under Dunbar. Rebound tipped around back to Ridgeway. Won't get the second shot to go, and it'll be tied up underneath. Arrow's going to point to the Mavericks. For the best news coverage of high school sports in West Virginia all year, follow Joe Bricado and Greg Carey's daily posts at WVMetroNews.com. Dowdy with the ball. Nice pass into Baker. Gets it back out to Ridgeway. Now to Dowdy. Hagee closes out to guard Dowdy, and he's going to have to go to Mann. Mann finds Ridgeway. Mavericks still have that 10-point lead as we're down under 3.5 in the first, and a shot from Dowdy is blocked, and it's tracked down by Agee. Agee's going to get it to Hagee. Here come the Cavaliers. Hagee gets a pass to McClung. He gets a three up and got it. Second three of the night for Braden McClung, and he scored in different ways than what we saw the first time around.
Yeah, it very easily could have been a whistle blown there on that three-point play. James, you'd be fortunate he's not on the line trying to get four out of that.
Ridgeway with the ball. He dribbles into the high post. Tries to get a pass to Mann, but it's knocked away, and it's going to be a foul on Ridgeway.
And just like I said about fouls, that'll be Cooper's second, as he's been really active all over the place away from the ball thus far in the game.
We'll have a timeout and let you know that drinking chocolate milk, the official beverage of West Virginia High School Sports, helps you recover for what comes next. It's delicious and contains the right mix of protein and carbs to help refresh exhausted muscles. For more information, visit drink-milk.com.
So we talked about the girls. Let's talk about the boys' championship. The 2024 West Virginia State High School Boys Basketball Championship for the Chick-fil-A will be held on March 12th through the 16th at the Charleston Coliseum in Charleston. That's Charleston, West Virginia, by the way. Come join the fun championship week.
These two teams vying for a trip to that. The winner's going to go. Loser's going to have to watch. So Farmers and Mechanics Insurance knows about West Virginia's history, is excited about its future. For more than a century, Farmers and Mechanics have provided reliable insurance protection to the people and communities across the state. Farmers and Mechanics Insurance Companies are proud to partner with high school sports and its commitment to teach and promote sportsmanship and citizenship.
So we'll see if there's answers to be given here as Wes has been cutting into this lead slowly but surely. Over the past few minutes now to a 7-point lead with 2 minutes and 50 seconds left in the half.
Yeah, potentially important. Four fouls on the Cavaliers this quarter. We in the bonus on their next one. Mavericks only with two.
McClung with the ball. He's watched by Will Baugus, his first time into the game. He gets a shot up from the free throw line and got it to go.
Yeah,
a little
Will,
shrug on the way back.
Will Baugus is a pesky defender. A lot of quality minutes off him as the season's going on.
You get it into Baker. Baker turns back out to Dowdy. He pushes up a three. That one won't go. Rebound fought for, and it's Dunbar comes away with it, but Mann's not going to give up. And we've got a foul. I think it's going to go against Mann. Be the third foul of the quarter on the Mavericks.
Yeah, as Baker got hacked on the forearm there. No call. Is, I don't really have an opinion about it either way, but
Maggie with the ball. 23-18 now. 8-point run from the Cavaliers and cut this back to a 5-point game. He gets it to Heggie. Heggie goes right side, picked up by Dowdy on the switch. Now Cole will switch out off the screen. Heggie gets a floater up. It won't go. Cole with the rebound.
He traveled a jump stop and then a jump stop.
Going to get that to Will Baugus in the corner. Baugus tries to go inside to Baker, and they're doing a good job of denying Baker the ball. That one tipped back out into the hands of Heggie. Heggie's going to drive in, and that ball taken away by Mann as he runs by. It's going to be a jump ball call. Arrow points to the Cavaliers.
Yeah, West player did kind of whip the ball over to his right side to kind of keep it away from the defender from Jason Reed. He kind of stuck it right up in his face there.
Into McClung. Hey. And offensive foul. I think they're going to say he swung the elbow.
Yeah. It's not a lot, but as you see, a lot of bodies hitting the floor here. These really contested jump balls and some fouls. The refs trying to maybe tighten up a little bit on this game, keep it from getting out of hand.
Yeah, Dowdy with the ball. He's going to make his way across. Still some pressure, and they're able to get that one as he tried to get a pass to Baugus.
And that was...
And trips as he tries to drive in. Looked like he went in trying to get contact.
Was
there was none
yeah,
there.
Was,
and just his momentum carried him to the ground.
He was anticipating that contact, and the defender just kind of stepped aside.
The old Ole.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now we're going to see real full court pressure, looks like, from West again.
Down almost to a minute to play here in the second quarter. And we'll have a contact foul. That will be on Dunbar. It'll be the fifth of the quarter. So Will Baugus will head to the line for two.
And that there's, you credit that 100% to Will Baugus. You know, as you know, if you don't have position, you can't use that out of bounds line as a second defender unless you've got position.
Yeah.
Greenbrier player did not have position.
We got to talk to Will Baugus the other night after the Greater Beckley game. It was all business, that guy. Misses on the first in.
It's a family condition there.
Yeah, second one will go.
Yeah, Will's become one of those players you see come off the bench for James Rowe. Just more and more as the season's gone on, become more and more effective as he does so.
McClung gets a three up. It won't go. Rebound brought down by Agee. Tipped around. It's going to be Cole who comes down with it, and he's fouled. He's going to go to the line. And we're already seeing that bonus we talked about a minute ago is coming into play. Now you're sending the best free throw shooter on the Maverick team to the bench from a foul 90 feet away from the basket.
Yeah, I believe...
Some moisture on the floor. We're going to have to get a towel out and get that dried up. Also, Bannon Goodman going to check into this game. Saw Bannon's come in and hit some timely threes and gets the front end. And it's going to be Mann to get in the break.
Yeah, that's a timely, good timely opportunity here to go to the line. As you know, Wes is ate into that lead. It'd be nice to build it back a little bit before the halftime break.
Shot goes in, and he gets them both. It's an 8-point lead now, 45 seconds to play, and it'll be McClung across midcourt. He's watched by Baugus, drives his in, and travels. They're going to call it. It's the same thing you saw a little while ago, was that jump cut with an extra couple steps on the end.
And pressure again on the inbound play from West. As now they just want to... want to prevent James Rowe from being able to get down here and run their offense and take.
And we're going to have another foul. And Dixon definitely didn't mean to give that one up. It's going to send Baugus to the line again.
And Baugus knew that.
That's the third foul on Dennis, on Dixon.
That is exactly why he pulled up and stopped there. He knew that he wouldn't be able to keep off of his back.
Got the first.
So credit all that to having played basketball a day or two before coming into this game by Will Baugus, by being able to create that foul and put himself back on the line.
Second one up and got it. So he's three out of four in these past two trips, and we're down to 30 seconds. It's a 10-point lead again, first half. McClung with the ball. They can hold for the last shot if they want. McClung has it down to 15 seconds. He's going to drive in, spins, and he's going to be fouled as he goes up. He can't get the shot. He's going to have two free throws. Comes with 12 seconds left in the half. Free throw up and good.
Yeah, that was Goodman picking up his first foul of the game there. Forgot he was in there.
Second one, good.
Well, 12 seconds. James Rowe got plenty of time to come down here and equalize or get those 2 points back.
Baugus gets it into the corner to Goodman. 5 seconds to go, and it's stolen away by McClung on the pass. McClung goes to Ramsey. Ramsey gets a shot up, and it's blocked, but I don't think it was actually going to get off in time. He had a hesitation on the backside.
There's almost just a hair, a little bit of taunting there after that play was completed. There's been some counseling take place there, and I doubt we'll see that again.
Yeah, a lot of West contingent here was calling for a foul on that, but what happened was he caught the ball, had to wait for the defender to pass, and buzzer actually went off where he got the shot off and before a foul could have ever happened. So everything that happened there was after. So none of it really comes into play. We're going to take a break, and we will be back.
The State Farm Personal Price Plan helps you create an affordable price just for you. Contact local agent Melissa Hilton for your personal price plan today.
Medical Center is located in the heart of Reno and has provided quality health care to our community for over 45 years. We offer medical, dental, pediatrics, pharmacy, behavioral health therapy, x-ray, mammography, diabetes education, and on-site lab services. We accept most insurance plans and offer a sliding fee scale for qualifying patients. Make us your family's medical home and let us care for you. Reno Medical Center. Excellent health care. Right at home.
Western Auto in Raynell is the solution for all of your automotive repair needs. We carry snow blowers, wood splitters, propane heaters, and a full line of Husqvarna saws, bars, and chains. And most importantly, service after the sale. We also carry Whirlpool washers and dryers, freezers, refrigerators, and hot water heaters. We have enjoyed serving our community for 48 years and support our Greenbrier West Cavaliers.
The 2023 West Virginia State High School Girls Basketball Championships, presented by Chick-fil-A, will be held March 5th through 9th at the Charleston Coliseum in Charleston. Come join the fun of Championship Week.
The West Virginia Secondary School Activities Commission serves its 286 member schools and their students by providing leadership and support for the conduct of education-based athletics, which enrich the educational experience of all participants. Play, perform, compete together. Today's athletic event is not about winning at all costs, disrespecting others, or criticizing the athletes, coaches, or officials. It's about learning and growing, developing character, and competing with class. Please keep it positive and bench bad behavior. The West Virginia Secondary School Activities Commission promotes athletics that provide lifelong and life quality learning experiences to high school students while enhancing their achievement of educational goals. Play, perform, compete together.
Chick-fil-A and its 18 West Virginia owner-operated restaurants salute the more than 86,000 boys and girls that participate in scholastic sports in our state. Chick-fil-A recognizes that participation in high school sports helps to develop leadership and teamwork skills that prepare each participant for life. The same values that Chick-fil-A in your community shares. Chick-fil-A, proud to support West Virginia high school sports.
Right, getting ready to come back. Have some stats here. Points-wise, Leighton Dowdy, 6 points off of the 2 3-pointers here. Cooper Ridgeway has 4. Will Baugus with 3. Ryan Mann has 4. Ryan Cole leads the Mavericks with 9 points. And Brady Baker has 2 for the Cavaliers. Heggy with 3. Davis with 3. Dunbar with 2. McClung has 12. All 12 coming in the second quarter.
Yeah, big surprise there. We talked about it, hit on a little bit in the game earlier, but they've pretty much made Brady Baker a non-factor down there. Yeah. They've done so without fouling.
Yeah, they've done a really good job of just denying the ball into him. When they get it in, they're able to tip it away. And we saw Greater Beckley actually had kind of a similar approach to trying to deal with Brady in that game, but Brady able to come out in the second half especially and make his presence known. So see if the adjustments are made to deal with that.
The West is doing a lot better job at denying the pass, at just interfering all sorts of different ways with the passing lanes. You see the balls that have been fed into him have been ill-advised passes, questionable passes at best. That a fella, particularly his size, is going to have a hard time handling. So we'll see if there are changes made, if they don't try to maybe start feeding the ball to him along the baseline as opposed to using angles from the full court.
About a minute and a half left before we get back into action here. Take a second to bring your attention to the spaghetti dinner and auction. It'll be at the Linside United Methodist Fellowship Hall. That is at 8764 Seneca Trail, Linside. And it's on Saturday, March the 23rd. Dinner will be at 4 p.m., an auction at 5 p.m. All those proceeds will go to benefit James Monroe High School project graduation for this class, the class of 2024. So getting ready to come up. I know they've been working for many years to put together funds and plans to have a great project graduation for this group of seniors. And, hey, it's only a couple of months away, and they're going to have that spaghetti dinner. It'll be a good time. Come out, bid on some things, have some spaghetti. March 23rd. We're getting ready to get back to action. We're down to 15 seconds left in halftime. James Monroe with an 8-point lead, was as much as 13. Second quarter, the Cavaliers are actually able to battle back to a 5-point margin, and Mavericks went on a little bit of a run at the end of the half that stretched it out.
Pretty much you could just about it. They pretty much, it's like each team reads the same script for each one of these games that they play. The math will be a little bit different, but the ebb and flow of the game, it's going to be just about identical.
Mm-hmm. Mavericks are going to start with the ball.
You know, in the past, we've seen James Monroe seemingly put this team away.
Three in the air right off the bat from Mann. He's not able to get it to go. Rebound brought out, and it's going to be Hagee to push it down the court.
I'm going to assume that was a set design play to come in and start this second half because that was an awfully quick shot. So
Hagee calls a play, comes to McClung on the right side. He's watched by Ridgeway. Over to Dunbar, now to Hagee. Hagee's going to drive baseline, comes back to the top to McClung. Gets a screen, now goes to the other side, down baseline, goes up against Baker. He's going to draw the contact on the foul as he heads to the line.
I wonder if, whether that's going to be on Ridgeway or Baker. They're both there, and it's kind of.
It's on Ridgeway, his third.
Yeah. He had an expression of concern on his face there when that whistle blew. So.
First up and good. Second shot, got it. Perfect from the line, I believe. Ball back out to Mann. Mann finds Ridgeway. Pass back to Mann. Breaks the press. Goes in. Now into the corner to Doughty. Doughty's going to come back toward the top of the key. 22-28. Mavericks with a 6-point lead into the corner to Ridgeway. Baker battling down low trying to find position, but he's covered up by Dunbar. Now Doughty with the ball. Works against Hagee, and he'll go back to Ridgeway.
Yeah, if he was just a step or two closer, he would be in good position to do that little jump hook thing there. So he had to play on his back.
Doughty tries to drive in, loses the handle, and it's recovered by the Cavaliers. McClung, he loses the ball as he drives, able to get it back. Now he finds Hagee, open three, got it to go. I was looking to see if it was a two or a three. I got the three signal from the official.
Yeah, just rolled right over the rim and right back out again.
Ridgeway finds an open lane, drives in underneath Dunbar and scores.
Lapse in defense there as they had a wide open lane for Ridgeway.
Yeah, and one defender there had his back turned to him. So, yeah, you can't play a defense like that. Yeah.
McClung drives in. Defense from Ridgeway causes him to lose the ball. Ridgeway recovers. He's across midcourt, gets it up to Dowdy. Dowdy's going to drive in. Shot up and good. 4-point run for the Mavericks. Stretches it out to a 10-point lead again.
I like the fact that Layton took that up with two hands instead of trying to just, you know, lay it in gently because he's anticipating contact off that shot. He was hoping if he did so, he'd have been able to pick up the basket plus one. And the ball stripped away again.
That's Ridgeway coming away with it. He's going to drive in, takes it to the glass, and 6-point run here for the Mavericks. All off of drives to the basket.
And turnovers.
Yeah, defense.
Three straight turnovers, 6 straight points.
McClung with the ball. He's going to dribble up toward the top and come over to the left side to Chris Davis. Baker comes out to help guard on Davis. Now he's into the mid post, gets it out to Hagee. Hagee drives in, jumper up from the high corner, and an offensive foul on the rebound.
Yeah, I believe somebody pushed man off there.
Yeah, it's going to go on Isaac Agee.
As we see, West going to slip back into their half court defense here. First time, maybe the second or third time this whole game, they haven't present some sort of pressure on the inbounds play.
The pressure's been effective throughout the game.
Yeah, the instant I said that West wasn't having any, creating any turnovers off of the press, they created like two or three in a row.
And double dribble. Yeah, Cole looked up at Coach Savage standing right in front of him, and Savage just nodded.
Yeah, you know. Cannot carry the ball. It used to be called carrying, stopping the dribble.
McClung drives in left side, goes up, and is fouled. They might get Dowdy on that one.
Like pretty straight-up defense by everybody there, just hands up in the air.
See who they call.
I couldn't see the number.
Cole, his second. Up, and that's the first McClung has missed.
Yeah, it's highly uncharacteristic.
And he doesn't get the second one to go either.
Two identical misses.
Up to Mann. Mann's going to drive in, gets a floater up. Too strong, rebound by Baker. He goes up and is fouled. Maybe Isaac Agee, we'll see. No, going to be.
I still couldn't see it.
I think it might be Dunbar. No, it's going to be Isaac Agee. Okay, I was right. Thanks, sponsors again. Mike Heller for Sheriff, continuing duty and service to our county. Greater Beckley and Webster County right now tied at 34. Got an update on that game. Being played in Webster County. Tough place to go play.
Yeah.
But also Greater Beckley, a tough team to beat.
And it's going to be
offensive foul. Going to be on McClung. Cooper Ridgeway got in there to draw that. I believe, was that Cooper?
He was. He didn't establish position as early as he would have liked to have, but early enough.
Cole with an open three. Got it.
And right now, look at that Greater Beckley-Webster County game. It would not surprise me at all to see Greater Beckley come out there with the win. Even though they have to deal with that rough environment up there, they strike me as a team that will win those close games.
Ridgeway comes away with a steal. He's going to drive in, gets it up off the glass. It won't go. Baker with a rebound, goes up strong,
and
a foul. Hope in the harm, and he's heading to the line. And we talked about it before. It contained Baker at the Greater Beckley game until the half. And that's kind of happened here as he started to break out.
And this here, he's creating his own assist, and they can't get the ball to him. Yeah, he positioned himself for a rebound and get the easy put back.
And shot up and good.
And the other thing that goes unnoticed, or not unnoticed, but unmentioned lots of times is his ability at the free throw line. You know, if you're a big guy and you're not good on the free throw line, you're losing such a big part of your offense if you can't score consistently from the three-point line. And he has such a strong shot there.
Absolutely. Timeout on the court as the Mavericks have stretched out a 19-point lead on this run here in the third quarter. And we'll take a chance to thank Elect Miller for Sheriff, Honesty, Integrity, and Commitment, as well as Kristen Cook for Circuit Judge. Monroe and Summers County's Republican running for a nonpartisan position. Hashtag Vote Cook. Appreciate all of our sponsors. You can catch them there on the ticker as they go by up in the corner. You'll see their logos. Impressive display from the cheerleaders there. Back handsprings all the way across the half court. The Mavericks have come out in this third quarter and have really just gotten things going on offense. They've been getting the ball into Baker more. He's been able to get some points. He's been able to draw some fouls.
A lot more springy defense. Not like overt in-your-face pressure, but really kind of pouncy, predatory-type defense.
I get the inbound to McClung. Has a screen set from Ramsey. Now backs off of it. Double team. Gets it to A.G. A.G. finds McClung back at the top, and he's watched by Doughty.
Levi Ramsey had a...
And the ball lost by McClung as he tries to drive in. Ridgeway takes it away. Gets it up to Mann. Head fake on Heggie. Gets a floater, and that's going to drop in. Sat up on the rim and fell. Clock ticks down to 3 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. Yeah, man, Mavericks have a 21-point lead. Heggie drives into the paint, gets a shot up, and a foul. And Mann went up for the block and got the wrist.
Yeah, get back to Mann on the other side there. Yeah, he put two really, really high arcing shots, high off the glass both times. The second time, he had really soft touch on those and got the bounce.
Got the front end. That's the third foul on Mann.
It's really hard to accurately shoot a layup whenever you're shooting the layup and putting the ball, you know, three and a half, 4 foot above the rim and hoping it's going to drop back down into the cylinder.
Second shot. Heggie got them both.
So there's a good bit of touch there for Mr. Mann on that last play.
Pass to Ridgeway. He gets across midcourt. He's going all the way. Shuffles a pass to Baker. Baker has position. Shot up. Can't get it to go. Dunbar did a good job on defense there. It was initially beaten. Was able to establish himself. Gets it up to McClung. McClung goes coast to coast and scoops it in.
Yeah, he's able to defend the ball, not bite on the head and shoulder fake, and not commit the foul.
Doughty with the ball. 43-26, 17-point lead now for the Mavericks.
This is James Ray wanting to spread it out a little bit, which we've seen them do.
They'll get it into Mann. Mann flips a pass to Doughty. Three up. Won't get it, but Cole there for the rebound. Goes back to Doughty. Gets it into Baker. Baker into the corner to Mann. Mann with the head fake. Drives baseline. Flips a pass to Cole. Wide open three. Got it!
And Mann should get one of those points of the three that, just for being able to drive and keep vision on parts of the court, you know, you just don't normally look at.
Yeah, Ryan Mann did a great job keeping his head up there as he drove baseline. Found Cole wide open, and we're going to get a foul on that side. I think it's going to be on Ryan Cole. And I think you're going to see.
From his emotions, it's going to be on him.
That's third foul on Cole.
But it's not. It
yeah. I think Mann either was upset that he thought it was on him to begin with or upset that he had just stolen the ball and a foul had been incurred. Could be either way. But first in good. Cuts it back down to 19 points now.
Well, you got to remember, we are just in the third quarter. Mm-hmm. And with these fouls starting to mount here.
And that one rolls everywhere. It pops out. Mann gets the rebound. Pass up ahead to Ridgeway. He has to go track it down. Now he's double-teamed, splits it into the corner. Cole
He had a wide open three, just couldn't handle the pass. And then tipped around, man controls, gets it back to Cole and now to Ridgeway. Yeah,
James Roque had several breaks there in a row.
Yeah, that inlet pass almost taken away. Man was able to recover it. And they get it to Man. He's going to drive in to the lane, into the corner. Cole's going to get a three from the other side and got that one. Really felt bad that he didn't get the one on this side, so he found one on the other side and picked it up.
As we'll have West taking a time out here. I think he couldn't believe that he was so wide open that he forgot about got to catch the ball first. And bobbled it almost out of bounds. He did a little bit to make up for there.
Yeah, it makes it a 22-point lead here for James Monroe. A minute 08 to play as we go to timeout. Half of a timeout, and we're back to action. Cavaliers control.
Yeah, a little bit of confusion about what defense they were supposed to be in. James Rowe coming out of that timeout. I think they've got it straightened out now, though.
You watch Hagee being attended to there on the bench. Looks like they're trying to rinse it. He might have bloodied a lip, trying to rinse his mouth out, I think.
Yeah, when he called timeout, he was pointing up at his face.
Yeah, they're trying to get his something going on there. They brought a trash can over for him, so keep an eye on him.
Rinsing his mouth out. He's probably kept able.
Yeah, hopefully he's able to get back in that game here shortly.
The basketball's not a contact
sport. Fourth foul on Ryan Mann. We'll see who they go to. I don't think they're going to leave Ryan out there with four fouls. They're going to get Dowdy back into the game.
I mentioned before with James Rowe, their foul trouble. If you can't defend, if you don't have the fouls and you can't defend aggressively against this West team, they will get right back in this game over a period of 8 minutes.
Well, Bogus gets the rebound off the miss. And under a minute now to play here in the third quarter, Bogus hassled tightly by McClung. He finds some room as he drives in, flips past to Cole. Three in the air. Won't go. Rebound. Out of bounds. Last touch, Mavericks.
There you go.
Davis with the ball. Tries to get it to McClung. Stolen away by Bogus. He's all up ahead. Drives in, draws contact, gets the shot to go.
And over his back.
Oh, puts it up over his head, reversed. Drew the contact, got the shot up off glass. The upstairs Bogus crew smiles over here beside us. And he's going to head to the line with a chance at three.
I tell you, you see, if you don't watch the game, though, he kind of goes unnoticed. But he's been a solid contributor off the bench all year long. And
leaves it short, but Cole there with the rebound gets it up and scores. Everything going James Monroe's way right now. And they've built out a 25-point lead with 3 seconds to go in the third quarter. McClung loses the ball. Ridgeway gets the shot off. Hits the rim. It won't go. Almost another state-worthy highlight from this Mavericks team.
If you look back the last three and a half minutes of this ball game, it should have went. Yeah. Everything else has been dropping for him. So,
I'm surprised it didn't go, honestly, the way things have been going. And we're going to take the break, and we'll be back on the other side. Don't go anywhere.
The State Farm Personal Price Plan helps you create an affordable price just for you. Contact local agent Melissa Hilton for your personal price plan today.
We're getting ready to get back to it. Fourth quarter of action. James Monroe's built out a 53-28 lead. I don't think anybody saw this kind of score going into the fourth quarter in this game.
No, I sure didn't. Spectator would be ahead by figured it would be a nip and tuck, you know, 6-8 points here and there.
Shot up from McClung off the front of the rim. It's Davis who goes up with the rebound, and he's fouled as he comes down. We'll see. I think they're going to say he was ready to come back up, and they're going to give him the shot. First foul on Brady Baker. He's done an outstanding job tonight of staying out of foul trouble.
Yeah, well, you know, he's done a lot of defense by position and hasn't had the ball brought to him a whole lot.
Didn't get the first.
Hey, you watch the Greenbrier Western body language coming out of that timeout. Downbeat, I guess, would be a proper description.
Long rebound out from Dunbar off the miss. Tries to get it to Davis, but he can't. But it's out of bounds on the Mavericks.
Yeah, it was a really sharp play there by Davis to cut hard fast to the basket there. And
AG inbounds. He's going to find Heggie on the left side. Three in the air. Oh, won't go. Rebound to Dunbar. Oh, no. It's Ridgeway who's able to get it.
Dunbar off of Dunbar's fingers.
Yeah, couldn't handle it initially, and Ridgeway took advantage. Long pass all the way across to Baugus. He'll set the offense from there as McClung steps out. Baugus. Dribble handoff to Ridgeway, and he'll be fouled. Put two hands on him. They're going to call you on the two hands.
Yeah. Yeah, which he was Davis was – he didn't have the speed to – he knew he was going to get burnt. So probably pretty smart foul to give there, I'd say.
Mm-hmm. Three in the air from Mann off the inbound. He can't get it to go. Rebound brought out. It's going to be – oh, it wasn't Mann. Sorry, that was Bannon Goodman. It's Goodman who gets the rebound as well.
Oh.
Nice pass from Will Baugus over to Brady Baker. No look.
No look at some mustard on that ball, too.
Ah, bro. Will Baugus feeling it here in the second half. Heggie drives in, gets a shot up off glass. That one won't drop. It's nothing going right for the Cavaliers right now. Shots that you would think are going to drop.
Shots that would be normally they would be making. They're just not falling for him right now.
Get it to Baugus. He got another pass to Baker. He's going to turn. Gets his body in. Shot up, and it'll go. Give an assist there on the delay to Will Baugus again. I tell you what, if Brady Baker, you can't find a way to get him the ball, put Will Baugus in the game, and he's going to get it to him. And they're going to get a shot up from AG. It won't go off the front of the rim. And the rebound out to Ridgeway. 6 minutes
play.
And that ball taken out of the air and then a foul. The mistake adds to a mistake there.
Yeah.
And you get the foul off of the turnover. And we're going to have Ramsey and Dixon check in.
It's going to
get Dunbar and...
past couple possessions.
That's six
there.
Players on the court right now. Okay, and then AG's going to go off as well.
If you're Brady Baker and you don't keep your hands up around your face and Baugus has the ball, you're liable to lose a tooth.
Yeah. Hopefully these guys are used to it. I mean, it was last year, talked about a couple passes Eli Allen had thrown, and what he told us was that my teammates know they better watch for the ball. So same situation. You better have your head on a swivel and watching for the ball, and it's a foul. Tanner Heggie's going to head to the line. 57-28, 5:58 on the clock. That's the first foul on Will Baugus. Shot up, and that one won't go. Out of bounds. We're going to have Ryan Cole at the scorer's table. He's going to check back in. He's going to give a break to Brady Baker. I think it's Brady's first break all night. Staff, loud cheer from the crowd as Brady Baker heads to the bench. Gives a scrub of the head there to Kate Dillon as he walks by. If things don't tighten up, it might be the night for Brady. We'll see. And that rebound out to McClung. McClung's going to go right side. Goes up. That's blocked there by Ridgeway. And then a foul committed as four Cavaliers were surrounding Bannon there and trying to get that ball back. And somebody had the foul. I'm not sure who. That's Levi Ramsey who picked up that foul. Just his second. Mavericks in no hurry now, and no discernible press coming from the Cavaliers at this point.
Yeah, I'd look for them to try to open up their end of the court here, James Monroe, and that's exactly what they're going to do.
Yeah, with 5:15 left to play, Ryan Mann back to the scorer's table, and Will Bogus gets in the lane again, gets the shot up, same situation as earlier, almost gets it in, but doesn't. He'll head to the line for two this time. And Chaz Boggs stepping up as well, so he's going to be coming into the game.
Yeah, Boggs having to put the ball up over the back of his head as he's rapidly passing behind the backboard.
Got it. And that foul also on Levi Ramsey, so now he's third. Cooper Ridgeway and Bannon Goodman are going to check out.
And I would anticipate that would be the last we'll see of Cooper unless things, unless the wheels fall off the machine here in the next minute or so.
Shot up and got it.
At this point in the game, you've got guys out there to protect the basketball, take time off the clock.
It's a 31-point game right now.
And
59-28. Yeah. I imagine we're going to see maybe some of these guys sitting down there still in their warm-ups get into this game as it gets closer to the end as well.
Well, there's no point in risking an injury to players who've been in the game the whole time. You know, injuries happen to tired players, and there were some tired ones out there for James Monroe starters. So, you know, put them on the bench.
Yeah. Well, James Monroe thinking ahead right now to a state championship run over the next week. They're feeling pretty good about it right now. That's the fourth foul just assessed to Chris Davis. And Chaz Boggs has the ball. Comes over to Cole into the corner to Boggs. Boggs back to the top of the key to doubt it. He finds Cole. Cole looking around, comes back to Boggs. He's going to push up a three. Oh, just left it on the front of the rim. Rebound to Doughty.
So it's a little bit longer, maybe another step in. It's a step outside of his range.
Boggs has the ball, comes back to Boggs. Gets a screen from Mann. Now he's going to drive into the lane to the high post, gets it out to Cole. Cole steps back in, finds Doughty. Ticking down toward 4 minutes to go now. Mavericks taking a lot of time off the clock. Gets a screen as Boggs drives in. Boggs to the hoop, he got it!
A little bit of English action on that ball to get that to spin around off the backboard and in.
Easily the best game that Will Boggs has had statistically all year. He has really come alive here in this second half. Been a big part of the catalyst that gave him this big lead and a foul as Hagee goes up. And we'll see who it's on. It's going to be, I think, on Chaz Boggs.
And speaking
looks
of Boggs,
like Cooper's getting ready to come back in.
He is. And speaking of Boggs, as they usually sit down, every one of those on the left side of the basket. Not a single time has he cut and went to the right side.
That would not in 100 years have told you that this would be how this game would go down.
No, not
from what I've seen
history,
from these teams,
yeah.
Especially when they get together this year. I thought this was going to be one of those nail biters all the way through.
Yeah, you know, typically it wouldn't matter. Either of these teams could be undefeated. The other one could have a two-win season, and they're going to be competitive when they play. You can't really set the odds on these two teams. And like you said, I wouldn't have expected this score at this point in the game.
Yeah, James Monroe sending a little bit of a message here tonight to the rest of the state that, hey, we're still around. We're a different-looking team this year, but definitely something to contend with when we hit the Charleston. They started that last week when they were able to beat Greater Beckley, and they're continuing here tonight with this display.
Yeah, this team, you know, certainly not an undefeated season, certainly not maybe as flashy, you know, style of play from this group of young men as we've seen in the past, but just as effective at the end of the day.
Shot up and good. Pass comes to Mann. He's going to head fake, drives in, and a blocking foul along the baseline. And he'll head to the line. That's going to put the Cavaliers into the
one
bonus.
One, yeah.
Third, fourth foul on Levi Ramsey, and the first in goes.
shot up, and that one won't go. Offensive foul. That's going to go against Chris Davis.
Yeah, okay. Definitely away from the ball. I couldn't figure out what.
And he's fouled out.
Yeah, that would be his fifth because he picked up two really quick.
Trying to get you an update on that Greater Beckley-Webster score. Haven't had an update come in a while, so we'll let that to you if we can get one. And an errant pass goes out of bounds. It's going to be turned over back to the Cavaliers with 3:20 to play. McClung with the ball, gets to the high post, bends, gets a shot up, won't go, foul. It's going to go on Chaz Baltz.
Yeah, there's nobody really in position to defend against that there. It's about the only thing you can really do.
Leaves the first one short.
He's dropped, that's the third one he's dropped off the front of the rim. Really, really uncharacteristic of him. That's more like it.
One to 62. Mavericks have it doubled up the score. 31-point lead with under 3 minutes to play. Will Boggs gets a shot up. That one a little too strong. Goes off the back iron. Rebound out to McClung. McClung drives left side. He's going to get a scoop layup and gets it to go.
Yeah, I don't think Boggs, he was shocked to find himself standing all alone there. And I think the Greenbrier West defenders were shocked to see that he wasn't driving with it.
We'll get a timeout. Wes, you can see the replays. He gets in there, just gets that up with his left hand off the backboard. Talented offensive and defensive player, Brayden McClung.
Yeah, it's after some of the performances he's put in here in this building, on this court, and losing efforts. You hate to think his season's ended.
Mm-hmm.
Him, much like the guards from Greater Beckley, you can watch those guys play all day and half the night and just smile.
Dribble handoff from Boggs to Ridgeway. Ridgeway's going to reverse, comes back, looks to go to Boggs, now finds Boggs instead in the corner. Boggs watched by McClung. You don't see any heads hanging on the Greenbrier West side, though, and they're still out here competing hard.
Oh, yeah.
Boggs dribbles away from the defender. Hands off to Ridgeway. Ridgeway's going to come left side. Looks for somewhere to go as he's watched by Hagee. Now he's going to hand back off to Boggs. Boggs drives in, gets a step, shot up behind his head again, and he's fouled. All three. He's done that three times, and they've all almost went.
Yeah, that's the only one that didn't bounce around the rim.
Go ahead to the line for two. That's the third foul on McClung. Shot up and got it.
You see number 12, Hines, and... I'm sorry, I had numbers wrong there, but Hines and somebody else checked in the game.
Yeah, that's your two seniors walking off there, Ridgeway and Cole. Last time they'll walk off this court, and they're able to walk off to a standing ovation from a fully packed crowd with a 31-point lead in the sectional title game, or regional title game, sorry. So pretty good moment for those two, and it is Jaden Miller and Caden Hines into the game. And Dunbar goes down, goes to a couple of defenders, and gets that up off glass. We're going to have another timeout called. Full timeout.
Okay, I thought James Rowe called the timeout. I was trying to figure out why.
lineup. Caught by the Cavaliers.
Caught by the West, yeah.
Well, after this game, we'll have a post-game ceremony. James Monroe will cut down the nets. They'll be presented with the regional championship trophy, and we'll get as many players and coaches up here as we can.
Yeah, look the next general election. They'll probably have to do a school bond levy to finance the nets that have been cut down between the boys and the girls teams
Fair
here in the past
point.
Couple of weeks. It's going to start cutting into the budget.
First time in school history that the boys and the girls team are going to head to state in the same year. So school's been around for, I think this is the 30th year of school. Opened in fall of 94.
97.
Yeah. Graduating class of 94 was the last classes at Peterstown Union High Schools. The school
the first year, I remember Denver girls played their basketball at the old Greenville Junior High.
Yeah, Greenville painted the entire court. It was blue, of course, for the Greenville Tigers. They painted the place purple, and it's probably still purple today if you go in there. Will Baugus is going to drive right side, scoops a layup off the glass, and got it to go.
Imagine that.
Explosive athletics shown from Will Baugus right there.
As Coach Savage is getting ready to empty the rest of the bench.
And we're going to get a timeout, I think, to get the sub. No, it's a foul on Chaz Boggs.
A little bit of a.
Yeah, Kate Dillon, Adam Vanskoy, and Bailey Ridgeway getting ready to check into the game. I imagine they will be coming in for, hard to say, Chaz Boggs, Will Boggus, and Banna Goodman, most likely, would be my guess. Shot up and good. I was right. 3 for 3.
About a lottery ticket on the way home.
I know. Under a minute to go now. 59.1 seconds. Mavericks have a 30-point advantage. Braden McClung with his second shot of this trip to the line. And it is off the front of the rim. No good. Rebounded out of bounds off of Ramsey. Now head back to James Monroe. And let's see. Greater Beckley and Webster County are tied at 56 at the end of the third quarter. That update coming from, that's about 20 minutes ago, actually. So I haven't had an update on that since. So last we knew, tied at 56. So a tight game, probably nearing its end as well. Another timeout. And Vanskoy will inbound to Hines. Hines comes back across to Vanskoy into the corner to Miller.
There's a quick foul there on
some of the guys on the court right now. Miller, Dillon, Hines, Vanskoy were part of that JV team this year, boys JV team. First time in school history, went undefeated this season. So more bright things ahead probably for this James Monroe boys squad as they head into AA action next year.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to follow these fellas as they take the skill they got. You know, they're still growing, still working through that teenage battle with your coordination. That it seems like it sometimes is a losing battle.
Hugs and emotion there on the Greenbrier West bench, and some of those seniors are coming off. And that is a part of this time of year. You don't know when your last game's going to hit when these playoffs start.
Pass comes across.
Yeah, there's a...
Aiden Crane has it. He's going to get a shot off. Not going to get anything there. Dillon with the rebound. Gets it up to Miller. Miller's going to run the court. Has Hines up ahead. Hines by himself. Lays it in.
These are the two teams you'd hate to see the season, end of their season. It's probably Greenbrier West and Greater Beckley. You just those.
Yeah. You get into this part of the year, and there's only eight teams from each conference going up,
yeah,
or each division.
Somebody's got to go home.
A lot of talented teams will not get to go. James Monroe will for the third consecutive year. They are region champions and are heading to state. And they'll do it at the same time as the girls.
Everybody start collecting up your toll money.
Yep. You got a couple trips. You got tomorrow to go see the girls, and you got next week for the boys. Maybe multiple days for the girls. We do not know. Going to have to go up and find out. We're black tomorrow night, and we'll see you there. We're going to take a quick break and be back for all the post game.
The State Farm Personal Price Plan helps you create an affordable price just for you.
Contact local agent Melissa Hilton for your personal price plan today.
Coming back real quick, Lady Mavericks getting ready to make their walk. They're going to head outside, go to state. They're being sent off right now. They wanted to hang around to see this game before they left, support the boys' team, and there they go. We're going to see them playing tomorrow night. Fun group right there.
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of entertaining on the court and off court personalities amongst that girls' team.
And I have presentation of the trophy. And there's Cooper Ridgeway bringing the trophy back to the team. Third year in a row. Unprecedented levels of success here at James Monroe with this boys' basketball team right now. And we're going to have some pictures taken, some nets are going to get cut down, and we're going to see who we can get up here. Just hang with us.
job, guys.
All right, we're up here. Got two of the players off the court. Cooper Ridgeway and Will Boggess are with us. Cooper, I think you had 8 points. Will, you came away with 13. Had a really big second half there. Tell me what you were seeing. You had a lot of success getting the basket and drawing some contact down there. What were they trying to do with you?
Well, we spread the court out, and, you know, we had they put somebody on me, and I didn't think could guard me, and I just went around him. And all that.
Simple as that?
Yeah, pretty
Simple
much.
Simple as that. Cooper, they saw you put up a couple threes here early in the game. Did you want to get them thinking about it?
Yeah, they were playing off of me pretty tight, so much so that I couldn't even get the ball into Brady. So I figured I might as well let a couple fly and make them come out a little bit, and it seemed to work pretty good.
Yeah, I think it stretched them out. I thought the first one you shot over that corner was going to go. It looked really good. But I think it did the trick. Second quarter, Brady was able to have a little bit more success. They were really focusing on keeping the ball out of the paint here early in the game. How did you guys adjust to that?
We just knocked down shots, and we made them come to us, and then we played our game from there.
Did you expect this kind of game coming out of here today?
We did. That's the type of team we are. We like to push the ball, and we play physical defense, and I think we did that tonight. So, yeah, I think I expected this.
Yeah, I think you made a statement here tonight coming into this one. Just got the word for anybody looking. Webster County has beat Greater Beckley 72-70, so you'll be seeing them up there next week as well. Team you saw earlier in the season, as a matter of fact. So you guys took on a really talented team here tonight, really handled business. Looks like a 34-point win. So third year in a row you guys are heading up state. Tell me about it. How's it feel? What's it mean?
We're excited. Just because it's third time doesn't make it any less special. I still have the same feeling I had the first time. It's just a special thing. It doesn't happen very often, so we're really happy.
Yeah, I mean, you've been in state tournament games, state championships, football state championships. How's this compare? They don't compare to each other, or how do you feel about this specifically?
It's a very good feeling. It's hard to describe. I mean, I'm very blessed, and there's not a lot of people that can say they've played in that many state tournaments or state championships or had the success we've had, so I'm very blessed.
Yeah, absolutely. There's an unprecedented level of success here right now going on. This may have been the last, you don't know, going forward game with Greenbrier West as James Monroe goes back in the AA. I mean, you expect that game will keep being played, maybe not as regularly, though. So what's it mean, this rivalry?
Just my last game playing, I feel like I got the last laugh. It makes me pretty happy.
Yeah, you were, you were a freshman the year that they won this game?
Yep. Yeah, I was.
And so you were still in eighth grade at that time. It's been that long. It was COVID year. There was all kinds of stuff going on. So kind of crazy. Will, tell me, what do you think about this? What does it mean to you going up to this tournament game?
Well, like I said last time, there's a lot that we got to live up to, and right now we're doing all right at it. So, be glad to get to Charleston my first time.
That's pretty cool. You guys, the girls got to go see some of the little kids at the elementary schools this week. You guys will probably do the same thing next week. Tell me about how that kind of thing is and the impact you guys think you have on some of those kids.
I think we have a huge impact on them. I know when I was in middle school, they had a huge impact on me. I looked up to all those guys, and I just hope we do the same thing for them. I agree.
Yeah, the kids are running down there right now, slapping five, talking to everybody, so they'll be excited to see you guys. I'm going to let y'all get back to your celebration, but congratulations. Enjoy this, and we'll see y'all next week.
Thank you.
All right, here we are now with Ryan Cole. You were down there doing some other interviews, so I had to wait on you for a minute. Hey, you were hot tonight, 20 points. You were nailing the threes, getting stuff up quick. How were you? I mean, it's not that odd of a night for you, but tell me how you felt in this.
I just felt good. From the first shot, everything felt smooth, felt like it was going to go in, and just shout out to all the guys for keeping on finding me when I was getting open. And I'm glad I could keep knocking them down.
You said before the goal for this team was a championship, and now you're going to get that opportunity. You're going up to state. How's it feel?
It feels great. It's impossible to put into words how excited I am to go, how happy I am that we get to go. It's an incredible feeling.
Did you expect this kind of game coming in here against these guys? I mean, a 34-point win?
No, I thought it was going to be a closer one because when we played here, it was only a 3-point game. We played there, it was a defensive battle, only an 11-point game. But we just came out in the third quarter and put them away pretty early.
Yeah, they actually had a run in the second quarter that kind of tightened things back up. You guys came out after halftime and really stepped on the gas. What did Coach Savage have to say at halftime that got you guys going?
We just had to step up on defense. In the second quarter, we started giving up a lot of stuff that we were holding them in the first quarter. But we came out in the second half and first half.
All right, we know what you mean. So the girls are heading up tonight. You guys are going to follow first time in school history. Both teams have gone in the same year. That's going to be big. I asked them about the girls went and read to the kids at the elementary schools this week. You guys probably get a chance to do the same thing. Tell me about the impact you guys think you have on some of those young guys.
We think we'll have a pretty good impact. We actually went today, the girls and the boys teams, went to Peterstown today and went. And me and Cade, Dylan, we were together, and we had a chance. We were in a classroom, and we were building block towers with the kids, and they were all over us, and they were excited to see us there.
Kind of a cool thing. I mean, everybody comes out. They watch. They come here. They know who you guys are, so when you walk in the room, you probably get some attention pretty quick, right?
Yeah, pretty quick.
Yeah, even here, I see the kids coming up to you and talking, and it's kind of a cool atmosphere. But IU's on tonight, so on to the state tournament. I guess we'll find out. Well, probably very soon who your matchup's going to be with. They'll have those rankings out as soon as the game ends, or all the games end, which we'll let you know as soon as that happens. But we're going to let you get back to the party. But great game tonight, 20 points and 34-point win here in regional champions.
Yes, sir.
All right, see you there.
I'll see you.
There's Brady Baker. Brady. Hey, 34-point win. Did you see it coming? Yeah, I think you guys had the advantage going into this game, but I expected a tight game, kind of what you normally see with when Greenbrier West comes in. Teams match up pretty well, but you guys really took it to a new level, especially there in the third quarter. You built this big lead. The first half, they did a pretty good job trying to deny you the ball. So what changed at halftime where you were able to get in there, start getting the ball, start drawing fouls and kind of doing your thing? How about a couple of them passes from Will Boggs? Yeah, Will did have a great game. Kind of reminiscent of when Eli would drive in and scoop that ball off somewhere. You had to keep your eyes open because you didn't know if it was coming. Tell me about how this feels. You're heading to state third year in a row. You guys are going to be going up there. In fact, every year you've been here, you guys have gone up to state. So what's it feel like, this one in particular? Yeah, I think you see all those seniors who left last year. There were a lot of people who were wondering what James Monroe would be able to come out and do, and you guys have answered that thoroughly. As you're building something special here, I think, with this program. Talk to the other guys about this. You guys went red to the kids today. You have probably going to do that some next week as well. Tell me about what it means to be able to have an impact on some of those young guys that look up to you. Yeah, absolutely. I'm going to let you get back to it. Guy Layton just stepped up here. We'll talk with him for a minute. But congratulations, third year in a row. There's Layton Dowdy. I asked the same question as everybody else. How's it feel? You guys got a 34-point win here. You head to state. Did you see it coming? All right, so as we were just saying, you got a 34-point win here. Did you see it coming?
Not that much. I mean, I figured we'd beat them by 15 or so. I mean, I knew we could do it. I just didn't know if we would. And we came out here, especially second half, third quarter, executed well and ran away with it.
Yeah, you guys, they had a little bit of a run there in the second quarter where they caught back up. You guys had built out, I think, a 13-point lead. They got it back to five. You guys stretched out a little bit. Second quarter hit, and you guys were off to the races. So mm-hmm. What happened at halftime? What was Coach Savage's message in the locker room?
He was just saying keep it up on defense and push the ball harder, and best offense is defense. And I think we proved that tonight. And then the second quarter, we just had to stay calm. They're going to make runs. Every team does. And then we just had to come back strong in the third quarter, and we did.
What kind of game plan did you guys have coming in for Braden McClung? I know he had a big game here last time he was on this court. What were you guys coming in expecting to do to keep him under control?
Just play our defense and try not to foul him. He likes to jump into you and foul you. Just not give him easy buckets. He didn't get very many. I mean, he made a few, but we'll give him that. I mean, we made it work.
Yeah, it seemed like they were trying to pack in a little bit, deny Brady the ball in that first half. And you came out with a couple of threes. Mm-hmm. Ryan had a few. You think that loosened them up a little bit? Were you able to get more in the second half?
Oh, yeah, I had to. I know they were packing in on Brady, which they should. He's hard to handle. I mean, you almost have to double-team him. So when we hit shots, it opens up for him. It's big time if we get a post-game going.
Oh, yeah. You guys got to go talk to the kids today, read some books. You probably do some more next week. We've been asking everybody about the kind of the impact you think you have on those young guys.
Hopefully it's a good impact. You know, they see the good and kind of ignore some of the bad. But, yeah, I think we have a good, great impact on the kids. I know I like looking up to them. I don't really realize how much they look up to you until you go there and you see all of them dancing around and wanting to get you a high five. But yeah, it's awesome to see those kids come out.
Yeah, you kind of look up to those guys ahead of you, and then you don't realize how much you're looked up to until you go see them, but they definitely do.
Yeah.
Anything you want to say before we break out of here? Looks like Ryan's come up. We'll get him here for a minute, but hey, otherwise, go enjoy the party.
Yeah, I know. Thank y'all.
All right, we'll see you.
Yeah.
All right, and now Ryan Mann's up here. Hey, same question as everybody else. 34-point win. Did you see this coming?
I thought we was going to bring it pretty handily, but I didn't think 34. I was thinking the more 15 range. I thought all year we kind of just, the first two times we played them, we didn't play very well, and I feel like we were starting to get things clicking.
Yeah, I think so. You guys, made a little bit of a run in the second quarter. You guys were able to build out in that third quarter, played a lot of good defense. You had steals. You were getting some fast breaks. So what were you coming in looking to do from the first quarter, and what adjustments did you make that led to that onslaught?
Well, one thing was getting back. We got beat back three times, I think, and that fixes some of it. And we were opening up too much on some of the players, letting easy to the lane. We closed that off and just play good defense.
Yeah, you're known as a defensive guy, but you had pretty good offensive night here as well. Tell me about that play you had where you were on baseline, you found Cole on the other side. What were you looking for right there? You kind of gave a little head fake, went around, and Cole was wide open.
Well, I dribbled to the baseline, and I thought Brady was going to be there for the cut because he usually is open right there, and then I just saw Ryan Cole because that guy crashed down, and I hit him.
Absolutely. Tell me about what it means just being able to go up to state this year. You know, I think Brady – Brady mentioned maybe – not everybody outside of the locker room believed y'all be able to do it this year after you lost you lost coming back from last year, but able to come out here, win like this, head back to state. Tell me what that means for you guys as a team.
Oh, it means a lot as a team. I thought we could do it from day one. I knew it'd be a little more of a paint struggle, but I knew we could get there. I figured on the people thinking we wouldn't be able to because we lost a lot of good players, so. But I feel like we just showed what we can do and play good defense.
Yeah, I think so. You guys have proved anybody who had any doubts about that wrong because you guys are going in. Hey, I think it's wide open for you guys when you get up there the way you're playing right now. I don't think anybody has any doubts now. But I'm going to let you get back to the celebration. That's going to do it for us here tonight. We might try to get Matt. I don't know where he's actually gone off to. But
yeah, I don't see it. Oh, there he is.
I'm going to go down and try to get a talk with him. But congratulations. Go enjoy yourself.
Thank you. Vote Scott Miller.
man.
Beautiful.
Oh, yeah.
All I'm coming to you.
Get a picture for the interview.
Get the picture. Get
your picture. Oh, no, you can tell me to hold it.
Okay.
There you go.
Which,
here you go, Wayne.
You want me to hold that?
All right, we're down here with head coach Matt Savage. Third year in a row you guys are going to state. Tell me how it feels. I've never had success like this here before, and the girls going in the same year, another first. Talk to me about your feelings.
You know, I'm not going to lie, it feels pretty good. you know, I was nervous all day today because West is a good team. I mean, you know, and, you know, to be able to make this trip three times in a row, to be honest, I feel blessed, you know. And I always tell everybody, you know, I'm old. You know, I'm just an old geezer that, you know, is trying to coach these boys. But what I love is the memories these boys are going to be able to make. And that's what it's about.
Yeah, this team really seems like it's come together. They told me they believed in each other from the beginning.
Yes.
Don't know if everybody else outside of the locker room did, but they never had any doubt they could come in here and do what they've done this season. And I don't know, topping it off with a 30-point win, a 34-point win against Greenbrier West, I don't know if anybody saw that kind of score coming.
No, and, you know, the 36 side I saw coming – I don't know if I saw the 70 side coming. You know, it's saying, especially the second half, third quarter. I thought third quarter is one of the best quarters we've played this year. You know, I thought we played really well that quarter. We were seeing the court well. And not only that, but defensively they were getting after it at the same time. And when you combine the two, you know, the third quarter changed the whole game.
Yeah, it was an 8-point game at halftime. It came out that third quarter and really opened it up.
So yeah.
What adjustments did you make? What did you tell them at halftime?
Well, you know, at halftime, we actually just made a couple small adjustments. We made one adjustment on defense, and then on offense, you know, there was two or three little small adjustments we made, but it wasn't anything major. But the biggest thing is, you know, we wanted to change their mindset. You know, get downhill more, you know, don't settle. And, you know, when they were getting downhill and getting inside, you know, because first half we didn't get it inside very much. And whether it was on the drive, whether it was kicking it into Brady, whoever it was, we just didn't do it much. And, you know, with this team, we've got to do that. We got to play inside out. And when we were able to do that, it opened up everything for us.
Yeah, it seemed like they were doing a really good job of first packing in, trying to keep the ball away from Brady, just getting hands in, passing lanes, that kind of thing. But it really opened up in the second. Hit some three-pointers. That might loosen them up a little bit, but and there are also some good entry passes that made it into Brady.
Yeah, you know, and I think the cool thing about that is, you know, when our offense opened up, I think West had to change their strategy a little bit. And, you know, we've been there. We've had to do it before, too. And it can work in your favor or it can work against you, you know. And so, you know, in that instance, it helped us.
So you guys will head up next week. We'll find out who you're playing probably very soon if we don't
already
know.
Yeah, probably next few minutes,
yeah. Yeah, I've been watching for that. I know Webster County won their game 72-70. It was tight. But what's your plan next week? Can you get a few days of practice, head up on Wednesday?
You know, I'm sure we'll head up on Tuesday evening sometime.
Tuesday, that's what I mean.
Yeah, and the way I've heard coaches talk, we're probably going to be – anywhere between 3 and 5 seed, probably pushing the 4 or 5 seed, I would think. And Webster's good possibility they're going to be 4 or 5 seed. You know, we'll see. We'll see where they rank East Hardy because I think they're the 3 seed in there. But, you know, I haven't seen it yet. But, you know, regardless, you know, I'll take this team and let's go play. You know, and, you know, tonight we're going to celebrate. You know, the coaches and I will start watching some game film tomorrow and get it going. But right now, you know, we're focused on it. It was a great win.
Yeah. I think there's probably a lot of teams up there that are worried about how that seed will work out and don't want to draw the Mavericks. That's what I think.
That's what
we'll
I'm hoping.
See. All right, we're going to do it here for us tonight. Mavericks come away with another regional championship. Boys and the girls will both head to Charleston. Girls are there tomorrow night, so we'll see you, and we'll see you next week with the boys.
Thank you.
The State Farm Personal Price Plan helps you create an affordable price just for you. Contact local agent Melissa Hilton for your personal price plan today.
Raynell Medical Center is located in the heart of Raynell and has provided quality health care to our community for over 45 years. We offer medical, dental, pediatrics, pharmacy, behavioral health therapy, x-ray, mammography, diabetes education, and on-site lab services. We accept most insurance plans and offer a sliding fee scale for qualifying patients. Make us your family's medical home and let us care for you. Raynell Medical Center. Excellent health care right at home.
Western Auto in Raynell is the solution for all of your automotive repair needs. We carry snow blowers, wood splitters, propane heaters, and a full line of Husqvarna saws, bars, and chains. And most importantly, service after the sale. We also carry Whirlpool washers and dryers, freezers, refrigerators, and hot water heaters. We have enjoyed serving our community for 48 years and support our Greenbrier West Cavaliers.
The 2023 West Virginia State High School Girls Basketball Championships, presented by Chick-fil-A, will be held March 5th through 9th at the Charleston Coliseum in Charleston. Come join the fun of Championship Week.
The West Virginia Secondary School Activities Commission serves its 286 member schools and their students by providing leadership and support for the conduct of education-based athletics, which enrich the educational experience of all participants. Play, perform, compete together. Today's athletic event is not about winning at all costs, disrespecting others, or criticizing the athletes, coaches, or officials. It's about learning and growing, developing character, and competing with class. Please keep it positive and bench bad behavior. The West Virginia Secondary School Activities Commission promotes athletics that provide lifelong and life quality learning experiences to high school students while enhancing their achievement of educational goals. Play, perform, compete together.
Chick-fil-A and its 18 West Virginia owner-operated restaurants salute the more than 86,000 boys and girls that participate in scholastic sports in our state. Chick-fil-A recognizes that participation in high school sports helps to develop leadership and teamwork skills that prepare each participant for life. The same values that Chick-fil-A in your community shares. Chick-fil-A, proud to support West Virginia high school sports.